Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin with the parents of the groom, Cindy and Walter Martis. The mother of the groom, Cindy, and the father and best man, Walter. Now let's welcome the father of the bride, Thomas Zug, and his wife, Susan. Let's welcome the mother of the bride, Hope Riley, and her husband, Bill Riley. And now our bridal party. First, give a great welcome to C.J. Hartman, escorted by Mark Nixon. Now let's welcome Julia Carraza, escorted by Winston Bragg. Let's welcome Joanna Ashley, escorted by Randall Naftal. Let's welcome Naomi Chadwick, escorted by Marcus Baer. Let's welcome Christine Gallagher, escorted by Ryan Spreto. Let's welcome Christine Procaccino, escorted by the groom's son, Keller Martis. Let's welcome Hadley Morris and Matron of Honor, Tracy Tackett. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, may you all please rise. It's time to welcome the bride and groom for the first time, Holly and Scott Martis.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. When you get what you want, but it's not what you need. When you feel so tired but you just can't sleep, stuck in reverse. When the tears stream down your face, when you lose something you can't replace, when you love someone but it goes to waste, could it be worse? If you never try, then you'll never know just what you are. Lights will guide your home and ignite your bones, and I will try to fix you. Tears stream down your face when you lose something you cannot replace. Tears stream down your face, and lights will guide you home and ignite your bones, and I will try to fix you.
There they are, the bride and groom, ladies and gentlemen.
Scott's extended family. I am Scott's Aunt Stacy, and this is his cousin Brody. 28 years ago, Scott and I did a rap for my sister Judy and her husband Frank when they got married. Scott was a mere teenager then, young teenager, and I was even a mere, I won't say what, but much younger than I am now. And so I thought it would only be fitting if I revamped the rap, did it with Brody, for Scott and Holly. So,
I said a hip hop, hip, a heavy and a hip hip hop, and you don't stop, rock it out, bubble to the bang bang boogie to the rhythm of the boogie the beat.
Now what you hear is not a test, I'm rapping to the beat. I'm Stace and this is Bro.
And we're gonna try and move your feet.
You see, something happened a while back, two people fell in love.
We know about that. Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
There was this hot chick, her name was Holly. In finding the right man, she showed no folly. Yo, she was beautiful, smart, and fun. A perfect catch, one and done.
Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
Now Scott, a man with two gifts in tow, searching through life with his arrow and bow, searching for love so true, happiness he'd find, we all knew.
Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
With humor, good looks, and muscles to flex, Scott arrived on the scene. He was up next. He knew with Holly life would be grand. He might also be able to have his feet in the sand.
Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
So just throw your hands up in the air and party hardy like you just don't care. For Holly and Scott, the day has come. Let's clap, high five, and give them some.
Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
Glasses, whoa, not yet. Glasses raised and cheer around. Louder and louder, I want to hear some sound. To Scott and Holly, we give a toast. We know together you have the most.
Love, love, L-O-V-E, a better couple there couldn't be.
So what you hear is not a test. We wish you love and all the best.
I'd like to welcome all of you here this evening. Thank you for coming for this very special day for Scott and Holly. Whether you've come from Texas, California, the state of Washington, Montana, Colorado, London, England, Indiana, Illinois, Massachusetts, Connecticut, New Jersey, New York, Maryland, Delaware, North Carolina, Florida, and the states I've forgotten to mention, or you've come from Unionville or Newtown Square or Bryn Mawr, Haverford, and yes, even Gladwin. Thank you for taking time out of your busy days to join this special occasion. We really appreciate you being here. As many of you know, Holly and I have been fortunate enough over the years to spend a lot of time in Cape May. And Holly was always inviting people over to the house. And I never knew whether they were acquaintances, friends, boyfriends. All I knew, there were a lot of them, and I could never remember their names. So finally, in frustration, I said to Holly, just let me know when I'm supposed to pay attention. Well, a little over 2 years ago, Scott came to Cape May. And this time, I wanted to pay attention. But more importantly, shortly thereafter, Holly said to me, Dad, pay attention. So please join this very happy father, and now a very happy father-in-law, in a toast to Scott and to Holly.
Past year and a half, we've had the great fun of getting to know Holly and her extended, well, very extended family. I mean, for a starting point, the most obvious thing I can say is the same thing that Meryl Streep said in her movie of the same name. It's complicated. We've grown to love every one of them. I just can't remember all their names. Holly has hosted us on several occasions at her great new house in Gladwin, which we absolutely loved. And this summer, invited us down to spend time at her beautifully restored, historic Victorian home. Everybody should have the experience of getting up in the middle of the night and going to the bathroom and trying to flush a toilet that was built in 1870. Her father, Tom, has been a great host as well. Last Christmas, he and Susan not only entertained us at their home, but showered us with more interesting gifts than I can remember. For example, I just finished the tube of toothpaste that he gave me, and I'm still working on the box of paper clips. Hope, too, has showered us with great hospitality by inviting us to her and Bill's beautiful home overlooking Ocean City on the bay. And finally, we've had the pleasure of meeting all of now, as of this week, all of Holly's sisters. I will eventually learn all of their names. This is a great family, and we've loved being made to feel so welcome and becoming part of it. Now, having said how much we like and admire her family, I also have to admit of having found a few idiosyncrasies that, in truth, make them actually much more fun. Tom, for example, is what we might charitably describe as a man who hates to throw things away. And is the only person that I know whose principal car is older than he is. I mean, when I say it's old, it's so old that Henry Ford reportedly used it as an inspiration when he designed the Model T. And Hope and Bill? Well, according to Scott, they visit garage sales almost weekly, like moths to a flame. Now, that may not seem all that odd, but what does seem to make them somewhat unique is that, according to Scott, they turn around a couple of weeks later and try to sell everything they've just bought at their own garage sale. Unfortunately, the operative term is try to sell, which any of you who have seen their garage in Ocean City knows what I'm talking about. I have to say, it's so stuffed with unsold items that the only car that fits into it is a Barbie mobile that they bought 3 years ago. And Holly, dear Holly, Scott assures me that she single-handedly keeps TJ Maxx afloat. Scott confirmed that he had to talk her out of buying her wedding dress there. Moving right along. However, I have to admit to being both proud and humbled to be up here. Proud to have had my son Scott ask me to be his best man. I suspect that not two septuagenarians, if I can say that term after a couple drinks, septuagenarians can lay claim to that honor. But as I said, I'm also humbled, and I'm humbled because I'm not sure quite what to say about Scott that you probably don't already know. Anything that would be news to you, or at least that would be worth a laugh. And that for me is a surprise. I have over the years been more than happy to talk at various celebrations about friends and family members in ways that were intended, at least in part, to enlighten audiences about whoever was the honoree, but more hopefully to generate some embarrassment wherever possible. So I would think I could come up with something to expand on which you already know about Scott, or at least appropriately embarrass him. After all, I've known him for every one of his admittedly advancing years. But I doubt that any of you want to see baby pictures of Scott or hear about the funny things he did in high school. That's simply ancient history. And most of you already, it's not that funny. He was funny in high school, but we're not going to talk about that. Most of you already know what kind of person he is today. A devoted father, a lover of classic rock, a volunteer in soup kitchens, a damn good athlete, and a first-class cook. So rather than telling you out-of-date or bad-taste stories, or alternatively, trying to convince you what a great person he is, I'm instead just going to return to the fact that I'm proud to be up here. And forget about being humbled for not being able to think of something clever to say. It's a true privilege to be Scott's father, and now Holly's father-in-law. I hope you'll join Cindy and me in wishing Scott and Holly all the happiness in the world.
I'm one of the sisters. One of the sisters. When I first met Holly, I thought she was an only child. Turns out I'm one of seven sisters. It turns out this family has grown in a wonderful and awesome way. I am the matron of honor because I have known her longest. I met her when she was an adorable, super amazingly adorable four-year-old. And like just so super cute. She's grown to be beautiful. But she was so super cute, and now she's super beautiful. But what I want to talk about is, as that course of time, I'm older than her, so you would think, as the older sibling, I'm supposed to guide her. But it turns out she has been my guide in life in a lot of beautiful ways. Some incredibly practical. Many of you know she's a phenomenal shopper. I am not, so every time I'm with her, I'm like, please, like, dress me, like, take me wherever, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, whatever high-end store, I don't care, just shop for me and tell me what to buy. But more importantly, she's taught me about how to enjoy life, She enjoys to the fullest. She savors life to the best. It's really phenomenal. Like, should it be, you know, that little shopping splurge that you might want to just, yeah, of course, buy that. Yes, you should. What would stop you? To, no, actually, we should sit in this awesome streetside cafe all afternoon drinking these fabulous sangrias because it's just a fun thing to do. So Holly has taught me to enjoy and to savor. Or, like, maybe we should fly off to Miami. Like, whatever. Like, it's fun. Let's have a good time. Her girlfriends are super fun. Like, we have a good time. It is fun to be with her. So, yeah. And this is going to be a really fun party all night. Also, then 2 years ago, two, three, I don't know, sometime, I was at the shore, and this fabulous guy is there who also savors life equally and phenomenally. And so I was amazed and inspired from something that I have a hard time embracing of sometimes the chore of cooking. It turns out Scott loves. So I love being with Scott when Scott wants to cook, because I'm like, yeah, bring it on. It's great. It's Holly's birthday weekend. We should have champagne breakfast, of course, because we're in Sonoma. And we should have champagne breakfast. So, like, this savoring life to the fullest, it's inspired by Holly. I am amazed at the match because you both do it. And then it turns out, I don't know if the Philadelphia Country Club has ever had a literally rocking bus on the way to church for the wedding. Literally rocking. Woo! Everybody in the bus? Like, please, that was... Woo! Where's Marcus? Yeah. So there's some fun people in the room. But so enjoying life, savoring it fully. But what I've most noticed is this sense of completion, the sense of Holly's uncle at the wedding today was talking about this intimacy and this connection. And I've never seen such a depth and wonderful connection. It's just phenomenal. So I love seeing that in the two of you, and you have it. And I am just infinitely happy that you're together. And so I want to raise a toast to you guys, and I'm happy to be part of this life, and I'm enjoyed. And where's my cocktail? Oh, there we go. To everybody. And to the party of the evening, Philadelphia Country Club.
You know there's a light that glows by the front door. Don't forget the keys under the mat. A child of star shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be a waste of time. Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal and don't cheat and don't lie. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone you love. I love you ain't no pickup line. I always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, and don't lie. I know you got climb, but
The bride and her dad, ladies and gentlemen.